Hey, in this video, we're going to learn how to read HTML form data with servlets. So we'll start off with a student-form.html. That's going to be our HTML form. We're going to gather the student's first name and last name. They'll hit the submit button. The request will go across to our servlet, student-servlet.java. Our servlet will process the request and then send back a response. So that's the basic idea here of having a servlet read form data. All right, so let's kind of walk through this step by step. So the first step is building the HTML form, and we've seen most of this before. So we start off with our form, and now the action equals student servlet. So that's the name of the servlet that we're calling. And then we set up method equals get, because we want to make use of a get request to that servlet. Then from there, we simply set up the HTML form fields. So we set up first name field, last name field, and also a submit button. So again, we've seen a lot of this stuff before, just a basic form that we're setting up for our example. Now, the one thing that's different here or unique that I want to point out here is that since this form is going to send the data using method equals get, this actually calls the doGet method in your servlet. All right. So method equals get will call the doGet method in your servlet. So you have to make sure that you override the appropriate handler method, or make sure you override the doGet method. Now the next step here is reading the form data in the servlet. So at the top, I showed you the first name and last name. And then at the bottom, this is the actual servlet code. So again, we override the appropriate method here, doGet. They pass in a request. The request object has your form data, or it contains the form data. So here I simply use an out.print line. The student is confirmed. And here I say request.getParameter. That allows me to read form data. So request.getParameter on first name, and then request.getParameter for last name. So those parameter names map to the actual HTML form field names. And that's basically it here for our servlet example. What we're going to do in the next video is we're going to move into Eclipse. We're going to get some hands-on practice, and we'll actually build this example from scratch. So I'll see you in the next video.